Welcome to Bible 180 Level Leviticus. Leviticus contains regulations and instructions for the nation of Israel, including moral, ceremonial, and civil laws. Leviticus starts with offerings. There are voluntary offerings to give thanks and mandatory offerings to address the reality of sin and guilt that can't be ignored. Some offerings were eaten by the priests, others burned up for God alone to receive. Value nowadays is primarily determined by dollars, but it was measured in agricultural terms then. So instead of giving money, they gave grain or livestock. Old Testament offerings show respect for God by giving back what is God's. It also recognizes that coming into God's presence is of greater worth than any or all your livestock. Aaron and his sons are ordained to serve as priests. Priests managed the tabernacle and carried out the sacrifices. Sacrifices needed regulation because they were important. They removed the problems of sin and guilt, which had driven a wedge between God and his people. Priests came closer to the presence of the Lord in the tabernacle, so they were required to remain clean physically, morally, and ceremonially. Two of Aaron's sons disrespectfully ignored God's commands and were killed to make this point. If you want to make a relationship worse, well then ignore requests and give people broken or second-rate gifts. Also, if God is really present in the temple, then it's disrespectful to waltz into his presence with your poopy sandals and sit down on his couch with your muddy pants. God graciously came to dwell in a unique way with Israel, most especially in the tabernacle. So Israel was supposed to be more pure and set apart because God promised to stay with them, defeat any enemies they had, and bless their lives and livestock. Since God is holy and he is life, it conflicts with his very nature to associate with death and impurity. Levitical laws demonstrate God is holy, righteous, and the source of life. Levitical laws always had a purpose, sometimes sanitary, sometimes practical, sometimes theological. Some laws seem weird to us. However, I think Dr. Fauci would heartily approve of many because separation and cleaning are the best way to fight disease when you don't have cures. Remember, the Israelites live in a giant camp with all kinds of human and animals. Extra precautions make a lot of sense when you can't go to the pharmacy or the emergency room. Right in the middle is the Day of Atonement. One goat was killed to atone or cover over the sin of the people, and the scapegoat was sent into the wilderness to physically remove sin from God's people. This reconciliation can only happen because Yahweh, the offended party, desires it. Like any contract you've ever signed, Moses ends his by promising the goal or payoff for fulfilling the contract and reminding of the penalties if you break it. But Leviticus was written so that Israel can be reconciled with God. He makes a way through sacrifice and removal of sin at God's invitation by a Redeemer who desires to restore, purify, and forgive his people.